डियर स्टूडेंट्स, इट इज़ अ कंटिन्यूएशन वीडियो ऑफ द सीरीज केमिकल प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ क्लोरोफॉर्म, वेयर आई टॉट यू अराउंड 6 रिएक्शंस एंड टू नेम रिएक्शंस वर लेफ्ट, दैट इज़ वन इज़ कार्बिलामीन रिएक्शन एंड अदर वन इज़ रिमेटिमिन रिएक्शन. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल विल टॉक अबाउट कार्बिलामीन रिएक्शन. सो कार्बिलामीन रिएक्शन इज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट नेम रिएक्शन, एज आई टोल्ड यू इन द प्रीवियस वीडियो. Very, very important name reaction. This reaction is a very specific name reaction given by aromatic as well as aliphatic primary amines. All right, remember, only primary amines, no 2-degree, no 3-degree, no secondary, no tertiary. So when these amines, they react with chloroform, they are heated with chloroform along with the alcoholic KOH. Then upon reaction, these aliphatic primary amines, they convert into their corresponding isocyanides. Okay, now let us understand this reaction with the help of one example. So I am taking one example of aromatic primary amine, that is C6H5NH2. When it is made to react with chloroform, CHCl3, in the presence of alcoholic KOH, see how reaction proceeds. Understand the way of reaction, okay? We have to make the main product, that is isocyanide. So to make isocyanide, C6H5N and C. Now this is isocyanide, phenyl isocyanide, which is obtained as a major product, okay? And now let us see the byproduct. To understand the byproduct, dear students, see here. 3H and 3Cl. So we need to have 3KOH. Because we have got 3HCl, no? In a way we can say that 2 and 1, 3 and 3Cl. So it means 3HCl. In a way we can say. So 3HCl, so 3KOH we require. And now they will get neutralized with each other. So as a result, we get here, see, 3KCl. Okay, and now 3H and 3OH, so 3H2O. It's very easy to learn and remember. Now I will take one example of aliphatic primary amine, like ethylamine. I'll take C2H5NH2 with chloroform CHCl3 and alcoholic KOH. Now when this mixture is heated, now you have understood that 1:1:3 is the ratio, 1:1:3. And the way we took out the final product, same way we'll take out. Now see here, C2H5N and C, this is your major product, ethyl isocyanide, okay? So now C2H5NC, ethyl isocyanide, plus 3K3Cl, so 3KCl and 3OH and total 3H, so 3H2O. So this is carbylamine reaction. This reaction is used as a test for primary amines, whether aromatic or aliphatic, okay? And see, isocyanides are the products. These isocyanides are extremely poisonous and they have very offensive smell. All right, so that is about carbylamine reaction. Now we have the next reaction, that is Riemer-Thiemann reaction. Dear students, this Riemer-Thiemann reaction is a very specific reaction of phenol. In this reaction, phenol, what is the formula of phenol? That is C6H5OH. It is treated with chloroform, all right, or even can be treated with carbon tetrachloride, CCl4. In the presence of caustic alkali, that is, it can be NaOH, it can be KOH. And when this mixture is heated, the solution is heated at around 340 Kelvin, then it results into the formation of, in case of chloroform, salicylaldehyde, okay? In case of carbon tetrachloride, salicylic acid. It is a very specific reaction of phenol. This you are supposed to remember, okay? All right, now let us see the way of reaction, that how it proceeds. So I will be telling you the step of the reaction. See, in this reaction, phenol C6H5OH is warmed with NaOH and it is warmed with chloroform. So I will be writing the chloroform in the way CHCl3 is the formula, no? I will write Cl, CH, Cl2. This OH changes into phenoxide, okay? So, means sodium salt. So, we get OH. H is replaced by sodium. So, we get ONA. And the ortho position, this is the ortho position of the phenol. Ortho hydrogen reacts with Cl of the chloroform molecule. So, as a result, we get here CHCl2. Okay. Now, this compound so formed further comes in contact of NaOH. Two NaOH molecules I'll write plus two NaOH, where loss of NaCl takes place, minus two NaCl, and results into the formation of ONA here, CH, which is bonded with 2OH, a kind, sort of gem diol. Now, this compound soon undergo dehydration, removal of water, okay? The moment water is removed, minus H2O, ONA here. Now, what is left here? CHO. This is sodium salt of salicylaldehyde. Now, this compound on further acidic hydrolysis, means treatment with dilute HCl, acidic hydrolysis, NaCl is lost, minus NaCl, and results into the formation of salicylaldehyde. What is salicylaldehyde? It is alpha beta hydroxyaldehyde, aromatic. Okay, salicylaldehyde is the common name. I hope it is clear to all of you. Now let us see this Riemann reaction with carbon tetrachloride as well. Now, in place of chloroform, now suppose we use carbon tetrachloride. So reaction is same. The way the reaction proceeds, it is same. Phenol is made to react with NaOH and carbon tetrachloride, CCl4 is the formula. So I will write CCl3 and it is heated. Okay. All right. Now here we know that H is replaced by Na. Phenol is acidic in nature, so it is reacting with base and changing into its sodium salt. And simultaneously at its ortho position, ortho hydrogen gets substituted by CCl3 from the carbon tetrachloride unit. So I can write here CCl3, 3 Cl are there. Okay. Now this compound is made to react with 3 molecules of NaOH. NaOH, NaOH, and NaOH, 3 molecules separately I have written. Now these 3 Cl, they react with 3 Na. With the removal of 3 NaCl, we get a compound which has the formula ONA, C bonded with 3 OH, an unstable situation, soon undergoes removal of water. Now with the loss of water, we get sodium salt of salicylic acid, ONA, and here see what is left, COOH, COOH, okay. Now this compound on acidic hydrolysis, treatment with dilute HCl, acidic hydrolysis, undergoes neutralization, okay, removal of, means substitution, of Na by H takes place here. With the loss of NaCl, we get here OHCOOH. Okay. Now, this compound is none other than salicylic acid. Salicylic acid. So, this was about Riemer-Thiemann reaction. I hope both the name reactions are clear to you. Carbylamine as well as Riemer-Thiemann reaction. Prepare them very well from the point of view of the exam. They are very important equations.